Welcome to the channel. I'm Vic, your host. So, lately I've been playing some quick matches with Lazio online, and I wanted to share my experiences playing with this team and make this review. So, is this a fun team to play with? Let's find out. In total, I played 8 matches, which ended in 5 wins, 1 draw, 1 loss, and 1 abandoned match by the opponent, where I was up 1-0 at half time. In total, I scored 16 goals and I conceded 5. And I really did have a lot of fun playing those matches. It turned out the team is more dynamic offensively than I expected, and I was able to create a lot of chances and score some nice goals. So let's start by taking a look at the squad and the 3-5-2 formation and the tactics that they use in the game. So the default lineup will probably look like this. You have Radu, Acerbi, Luis Felipe in front of Strakosha. Then you have Lucas Leiva as the anchor in the midfield. From left to right in the midfield you have Lulic, Luis Alberto, Milinkovic-Savic and Lazzari. And on top you have Joaquin Correa and Immobile. I didn't make a lot of changes to this lineup. The only thing I did was to swap the positions of Radu and Acerbi in the back. And that's just because I like to have build-up, have center backs with build-up playing style on the sides. Because when I start play from Strakosha, I like the players to have some passing skills. I don't know if it matters that much actually in game, but I like to play like that. In some games, I had to bench Correa because he had a red form arrow. And then I pushed up Milinkovic-Savic as the second striker and I started Parolo. So basically that was the two starting 11s that I used. The nice thing about Parolo is that he has the whole player playing style, the same as Milinkovic-Savic. So when you play them in midfield, they will push a lot forward during the attack and will give you an extra forward. So the main assets on the attack is probably, as you already know, it's Immobile up front, and then you have Milinkovic-Savic and Luis Alberto in the midfield. And other key contributors were Correa and Lucas Leiva. Immobile has a lot of good skills for a striker in this game. As you can see here, he has very good offensive awareness, finishing, heading, kicking power. He also has good stamina. And as you can see here, he has acrobatic finishing, first time shot and heading, which fit perfectly when you have good crossers. If we take a look at Milinkovic-Savic, he is a whole player. He inspires low pass, so he creates a lot of movement when he has the ball. He has good passing skills, good ball control, he can head the ball, he is pretty powerful, he has good kicking power and physical contact, so he's a really good option up front when he's playing there with Immobile. And as you can see here, he has the heading and he also has some passing skills, one touch pass, no look pass, and he can shoot from range. I didn't do that too much with Milinkovic-Savic, but he has the skills in case you want to use it. And also Luis Alberto, as you can see, inspires both low and lofted pass with 2 stars. So he really creates some movement when he has the ball. And his passing skills and ball control are excellent. He also has some good curl on the ball. And his traits, a lot of skill moves, I didn't use too much of them. But he has through passing, weighted pass, pinpoint crossing, and one touch pass. Then we have Lucas Leiva, defensive midfielder, also inspires low pass and lofted pass. He has good stamina and decent passing skills. As you can see, he has also interception, and fighting spirit. Also the defenders, if you take a look at Acerbi, he has heading, fighting spirit. Radu has interception and fighting spirit, and Luis Felipe has interception, so he can cut off a lot of passes coming through. And that always helps if you like to press, like I do. So the wingers in this formation are Lulic, which is a pretty decent midfielder. Box to box playing style, not your typical winger. He is also right-footed, playing on the left. So he has to cut inside to make good passes with precision with his right foot. As you can see, he has decent passing skills, decent speed. Nothing to get excited about, but it's okay. He can shoot from range and he can cross very good. And he's also the captain, and he also has fighting spirit, giving the team an extra boost. On the right we have Lazzari, who turned out to be a really key player. He inspires lofted pass, as you can see, and he has really good passing skills. 84 lofted pass, he also has some speed, I didn't use that too much, but his lofted pass and curl and pinpoint crossing made that I used him a lot on early crosses into the box, and I scored a lot of goals that way. So with this composition, there is some good movement when attacking, and there's almost always a couple of passing options available. If we take a look at the advanced instructions, I used centering targets because of the quality of the strikers that we have. And also we have good crossers, so that was my main offensive tactic. And in defense, I used to swarm the box. When playing online, I want the opposition to shoot from distance. There's not a lot of players that are good distance shooters. They almost always try to play it in the box and finish inside the box. So I try to stack the defense inside and try to prevent as many shots as possible. Another good aspect of the offense are set pieces. I created a lot of chances on corners and free kicks. And there you have Luis Alberto taking the corners with 86 corner skills. He also took the free kicks with his 83 free kick skill. And in the box, I used to push up Acerbi, and I also pushed up Radu and Milinkovic-Savic. Immobile is good in the air, but he's already up there, no need to select him. Also Parolo is pretty good when he plays, and when he plays, Milinkovic-Savic will be the second striker, and he will be in there either way. So then you will have five good options on corners and free kicks. Immobile, Milinkovic-Savic, Parolo, and then Radu and Acerbi. So when playing the games, what turned out to work best for me personally was to build up the play using short passes until space opened up, and then try to break through. Or I try to get Lazzari open on the right side, and then use him to cross early into the box. Also, I tried playing out from the defense, tried to find Luis Alberto open, and then having him feed the ball towards the forwards or out to Lazzari. So let's take a look at these Lazzari crosses with some build-up play. This worked really well in most matches and was the formula for a bunch of my goals. So to summarize, Lazio is a team that rely on possession passing, crosses into the box and set pieces, and while that may not sound that interesting compared to playing with a high-paced team, I actually enjoyed this style of play. I would definitely recommend playing with Lazio, and if I were to give it a score, I would rate it 4 out of 5. Okay, so it's time to wrap up the video. Here's some of the goals I scored, which I haven't shown in this video yet. I hope you enjoyed this review. What are your tactics and style of play when using Lazio? Please leave a comment below. For my next review, I will play with Manchester United. Hope you'll want to stick around and consider subscribing for more videos like this. Thanks for watching and see you next time.